I do feel smarter. Hello there. You are joining me on Unboxing Things, a show where we unbox your favorite e-commerce brands. We talk all about the box because I'm Jessie Janae, co-founder and CEO of Lumi, and we like packaging. So I'm going to open my giant mailbox, which has a crazy door on it, like this, and I'm going to see what's in here. All right, I'm going in. You guys, we have Felix Gray. Felix Gray makes blue light glasses that help protect your eyeballs from your screens, because all of us are putting in a lot of screen time these days. Let's take a gander at this box. First up, Avioso, I can tell that this is a fully printed exterior box. What's more? Well, it's also glossy. How does a box get glossy, you might wonder? Because if you've seen a piece of corrugated, you know that that piece of craft board isn't glossy. How does one make it so? You don't, actually. What happens is this is most likely a litho-laminated box. What does litho-lam mean? I'm gonna tell you. What it means is that there's actually a glossy sheet of paper that was printed with this beautiful Felix Gray design, and then at one point, the glossy sheet of paper and the corrugated are brought together in a marriage, and like a sticky marriage. Basically, they were laminated. Let's just leave it at that. So, what else can I tell? Well, they're using the shipping label going around the side of the box and actually using it to close the box. So this box does not also have a big piece of tape or another sticker. They're just using the shipping label. I do want to say that while this is successful and you've got the scannable actual code here for scanning the box into the distribution centers and to the carrier, you can have issues folding a label over a box if you're not really careful. Clearly, Felix Gray is making it work, but sometimes in fulfillment, if the label is put on askew, then it has a hard time scanning. And a box that doesn't scan is a box that doesn't ship. It's really a box that usually gets stuck in a distribution center somewhere and not on its way to your customer. So I received this just fine. Felix Gray is just fine, but that's a watch out. This print is really cute. So you've got the actual logo here in a box and it's reversed out. I love how they're doing this to kind of just draw attention to the brand name Felix Gray. On the side here, some fun little sentences, happy eyes await, which is really cute. And then the illustration itself, you've got someone working at a laptop, someone working on an iPad, looking at their phone, on a skateboard on a phone. Now, they don't have a safety disclaimer here, but I'm just about to tell you that is dangerous. I'm going to find my handy dandy blade and I'm going to open the box. So I'm going to now open the rest. I can see that the interior is also shiny and it's this beautiful blue color. It also has really great print fidelity because that's something else you get from this process. Think about this. You know how a corrugated piece of material is corrugated? It's got those wavies. When you run that wavy material through a printer, you can only get so much detail because you're printing onto a wavy surface. Whereas when this sheet of paper, this glossy sheet of paper is printed separately, you can get a lot more print fidelity. So you've got a really detailed QR code, you've got really detailed kind of social handles and really detailed illustration, but that's why this box has more print fidelity than another box you might see. Now, because of that and its additional processes, it usually does add additional cost compared to a direct print box, but it can be worth it. It creates a really beautiful impression. In here, there's also a custom insert. Now, even just by feeling, even though you probably can't see this yet, the custom insert is not a litho label or litho lamination. It doesn't need that. It is a beautiful color match of the rest of the packaging, but this is just a direct print, and I can tell because of the way that it feels, and also the way that it looks, it's not shiny, etc. Now, there's a kind of hidden cool component of this insert, which is, look at this, I ordered two pairs. Boom, look at this side. This side has room for three pairs, and you can see evidence of how the insert came. The insert came and this was just a flat surface, and you actually push this in to create room for the glasses. So that's happening at fulfillment. If you open this, you can see how this insert looked in production. If you fold the flaps back, you can tell this is just a single piece of material. And it started white, white. How can I tell? Well, this blue color would never be this bright of a blue if it was printed over a craft color. So I can tell that this piece of corrugated material started white on this side, still white, and white on this side, and then this side was flood coated with this blue Pantone ink. These blue colors are a really nice match. I can tell I'm looking in person, you can probably tell on the screen as well, but they're not just like completely identical. You know how colors look different when they're wet versus when they're dry? They look a little bit darker, a little bit richer, and honestly just have a whole different kind of character to them. Well, that is taken into account with the Pantone color system. When you are choosing Pantone colors for your packaging, you must specify coated or uncoated. Now, you can't just magically make a coated color on an uncoated material. In this case, there's uncoated materials and coated materials, and they had to match it up as best they could. But if you've chosen a coated or uncoated Pantone value for your brand color, you may have to find the approximate other value when you're making your packaging to make sure everything looks as closely matched as possible. Let's see what these boxes are made of. And if you're saying, corrugate, Jesse, obviously, I would have to say to you, you're sassy. And what I mean is, I wanna find out which fluting they're made of. And I'm going to use my flute identifier to see if I can identify the fluting. Yep, just as I suspected. We've got an E flute. We have an E flute box. E flute is a little bit less common than a B flute in terms of just how much gets used, but an E flute is a really sturdy board, a little bit thinner than a B flute, about 30% thinner, which means you can fit more boxes on a pallet, more efficient storage, and for an item that is this lightweight, you don't need the thicker material, definitely don't need a double wall, which is two pieces of material bonded together. And so E flute does the trick and is actually an excellent material. Let's unfold this box just so you can see the construction of it. This box is kind of a standard mailer style box overall, and it has the actual cherry lock flaps so that when you fold up this box, it's not really possible for any dust to get inside, which again is good because you don't want dust on your glasses. Find out everything you need to know about your new Felix Grays, and it has a QR code and also shopfelixgray.com/letsgo. Where's my phone? Where is my phone? Now, I love a good QR code. Oh yeah, it's going there. So it's taking me and it says, welcome to the Felix Gray Club. This is a really innovative way of giving me more information directly during my unboxing experience without including more printed materials in the box. Often you see me when I unbox, there's a printed pamphlet, a catalog, a postcard, and I love that way of doing things too, but this is an interesting alternative. I most likely have my phone on me when I'm unboxing because I have my phone on me at all times. What do you guys think? Do I look? How do I look? You can't talk back, but if you would leave comments, I would love that. I would appreciate that. I think it's time to roll in the recap. Felix Gray, making a really incredible product for modern problems and modern eyeballs, but let's talk about what I love about their packaging. It's one, digital. What do I mean by that? This box is not digital, but the fact that they're pushing me via QR code and via URL to get more information online means they're not wasting printed paper and other information just to put it in the box. They push me to the online experience and they push me into a great environment for learning online, and I love that. Next, it's adaptable. Whether you got two or three, this insert is made to adapt so that you can order the amount you want, and Felix Gray doesn't have to have multiple different boxes to serve that need. That's some great packaging engineering. And third, it's cute. What do I mean by that? Well, I mean that these illustrations are really well designed. I love the thought and the fact that it takes into consideration human beings looking at screens in so many different environments. And then the interior is fully printed. The insert matches this blue color. When you get this, you're like, this is cute. I love this experience, and it makes you have a feeling for the brand itself. This has been Felix Gray Unboxed.